Dear students, continuing with our lecture series on named reactions, in this lecture we will know the mechanism and applications of Heck reaction, which is a very important reaction in organic synthesis. So Heck reaction is also known as Mizoroki-Heck reaction, because during the discovery of this reaction, Mizoroki and Heck, they studied this reaction simultaneously under different conditions. And here basically what happens is that when unsaturated halide or triflate is reacted with an alkene in presence of a base and a palladium catalyst, we will get substituted alkenes as products, and the alkene formed, they are trans alkenes. And because of the discovery of this reaction, the 2010 Nobel Prize in Chemistry was given to Heck for the development of this reaction, because this was the start of the organic synthesis where the carbon-carbon bond formation reactions they were started from here. So basically Heck gave us the first example of carbon-carbon bond formation. So Heck reaction is an important milestone in organic synthesis. So in case of Mizoroki, he used palladium chloride, potassium acetate in methanol at 120 degree centigrade to study this reaction of styrene reacting with phenyl iodide to give us this type of trans alkene as the product, whereas Heck used palladium acetate in presence of N tertibutyl amine as the catalyst along with the palladium, and he did the reaction under solventless conditions at 100 degrees centigrade. The same reaction was studied by both the scientists, and both got the same product but under different reagents or different conditions. Mizoroki obtained 90% of this product yield, whereas Heck obtained 75% of the yield. So because this was the first report for formation of a carbon-carbon bond in case of organic chemistry, that is why Heck reaction is an important reaction. So overall mechanism of this reaction is that in the first place, palladium ligand with zero oxidation state undergoes oxidative addition with the alkyl halide to give us this type of palladium intermediate, where the oxidation state of the palladium is 2. So palladium 0 is converted into palladium 2 oxidation state on oxidative addition of the alkyl halide. And then this palladium 2 intermediate reacts with the synolefin, and this synolefin is inserted into the palladium complex like this, with the elimination of the this insertion take place between the palladium and the this R substituent, and we will get this type of palladium 2 intermediate where alkene is inserted in the palladium complex, and then the hydrogen at this beta position. This is alpha carbon to palladium, this is beta carbon to palladium. And hydrogens present at beta carbon, they are called as beta hydrogens. So, beta hydride is eliminated from here, and we will get this type of alkene as the product, which is a trans product or E product. The orientation of elimination is such that the product formed is exclusively E product. Referential formation of E product take place in case of Heck reaction, and this hydride will get attached to the palladium complex, and we will get this type of palladium intermediate. And here again, the oxidation state of palladium is 2, and then in the presence of base, the HX is eliminated, and palladium 2 is again converted into palladium 0, and this can again undergo a cyclic reaction to produce more and more of the product. That is, E product can be formed. So this is the basic mechanism of Heck reaction, where it involves the formation of palladium intermediates. Then Heck reaction can also give us asymmetric products. For example, if we are having phenyl triflate reacting with dihydrofurane in presence of palladium catalyst, then we will get this type of chiral product formation, this carbon-carbon bond formation between this benzene ring and the furan will take place, and we will get these types of asymmetric product. And the palladium ligand which is used in this reaction is this palladium. Then similarly, one more example is these types of substituted pyrroles, dihydropyrroles. Ethyl 2,3 dihydro 1H pyrrole 1 carboxylate, this substrate, when this is reacted with this type of cyclohexene carboxylate, this type of substrate, this will undergo elimination of this triflate and a hydride at the pyrrole in presence of chiral palladium catalyst to give us these types of asymmetric products through carbon-carbon bond formation. So, with the removal of triplet from this, the ortho position of this pyrrole will undergo reaction to give us these types of chiral products with 99% enantiomeric access. And overall yield of the product formed is 95%. Then few more applications of Heck reaction, where the heteroaryl substituents, they act as alkenes to add on to the aryl halides. For example, iodobenzene, when reacted with 1,3-thiazole, we will get these types of substituted thiazoles as products of Heck reaction in presence of these palladium catalysts. So basically what happens is, in the first step, this aryl halide will undergo reaction with the palladium ligand in zero oxidation state, and oxidative addition of this aryl halide will take place to convert this aryl halide into palladium 2 intermediate. Then this palladium 2 intermediate will react with the thiazole, which will act as an olefin, and this will be inserted between palladium and the aryl. This thiazole, 1,3 thiazole, will be inserted between palladium and this benzene ring to give us this type of intermediate. And then beta hydride elimination will lead to the formation of these types of phenyl substituted 1,3-thiazoles as the product. So basically here the heteroaryl which we are using is acting as an alkene to give us a product with formation of a carbon-carbon bond. So this was an example of intramolecular Hec reaction. The Hec reaction can also take place intramolecularly. So for example, here this part is acting as aryl, whereas this part is acting as alkene. So both of these they will undergo Hec reaction in presence of palladium acetate to give us these types of heterocyclic products with formation of a new carbon-carbon bond. Then another example of Hec reaction where hetero aryl halides they are used. So these types of pyrazine halides, they react with benzoxazoles. This will act as an alkene over here, and this carbon will get attached to each other for the formation of a new carbon-carbon bond under the conditions of Hec reaction. Then some more examples of intramolecular Hec reaction. You can see over here, this part of the substrate will act as the alkyl halide part, whereas this part will act as an alkene. So a new carbon-carbon bond formation will take place at these positions, and we will get these types of product where a carbon-carbon bond has been formed between alkyl halide and the alkene to give us these types of products in 70%. Of course, in presence of palladium catalyst. All these reactions, they are taking place in presence of palladium acetate. So here also, this will act as an alkene. This will act as an alkyl halide, and cyclization will take place at these positions, and we will get these types of products through intramolecular Hec reaction. Then in these types of substrates also, this will act as an aryl halide and this will act as an alkene. And in presence of palladium trivinyl toluyl acetate as the catalyst, these will undergo cyclization at these two places to form a new carbon-carbon bond to give us these types of. So these are the different literature which have been consulted for preparing this lecture. Thank you very much.